We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Turn up. Work so hard, now shit's about to take off. Did free shows, now nigga getting paid off. Rappers act tough, but we know you niggas straight soft. So turn up, I'm about to go AWOL. On that piece of rock, got your boy laying, shining in the club, got my diamond straight blinging. Gotta watch these niggas, cause you know they out here scheming. Fuck around and hear that old fat lady singing. Catch me in your venue, turn it to the max. All the girls choosing, cause I'm crazy with the swag. And I got my eye on your girl if she bad. Took a couple days, now she chilling at my pad. Fucked a couple times, now I just might give her back. But she don't wanna come back.
Why you don't
she say you hella whack. I said, I'm from where I'm from. Got the bigger blues with no snakes, y'all. Call her Willie K, y'all. Finally, you know it's sweet, y'all.
Ride so hard now, she's about to take off. I ain't 7 days, man, yeah. Think I need a day off. Whole team all alert, we playing in the playoff. Shine and know you haters, but I'm blind, you niggas. Reach out, reach out, I'm blind. Reach out, I'm blind. Reach out, I'm blind. Reach out, I'm blind.
What up, what up, what up, and welcome to another edition of the Staci Harris Show. And in the building today, we have my co-host. He is currently starring on TV Land's hit new show, The Soul Man. We got actor Wesley Jonathan in the building.
Yeah, West Coast.
And we have a new up-and-coming artist in the building right now. He goes by the name of Aaron Fresh. What up, Aaron?
How you doing? Yeah, I like that. I feel welcome. There we go.
How you feeling?
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling real good. I'm glad to be here. I thank you guys for having me here. You know what
I'm saying? Absolutely, man.
So tell us, Mr. Fresh, what do you do? What are you known for?
I am known for singing and dancing, of course, because I am an artist.
Okay.
I also do TV hosting.
Mm-hmm.
I did the 2011 Kids' Choice Awards pre-show.
Nice.
Where I was like on the main stage and, you know, I was interviewing a whole bunch of different people. My first time ever, I lost it. It was absolutely amazing.
Yeah. a lot of energy in those.
Yeah, so, yeah, man. It was a lot of fun. And then yeah, that's pretty much it right now. Like and right now I'm getting my first project together that's releasing early next year. We don't know the exact date yet.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah.
Okay.
That's what's up.
And
man,
so you are under Mr. Nick Cannon, right?
Yeah.
Incredible Entertainment?
Yeah. I was under Incredible alongside with Def Jam.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
And we put out our first single, Spinning on My Time, which
mm-hmm.
earned like almost 5 million views and like it's popping. So,
wow.
Yeah. Oh, that's what's up.
Right on, man. Yeah. Now how'd you link up in with Nick? How did you get, you know, hooked up with him?
It was with my producer that discovered me by my friend's house. We was practicing for a school talent show.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And Rio Mitchell, he was walking by. I heard her singing. He was like, yo, come to the studio. He knew Nick Cannon's business partner. Nick came through to the studio. Boom, bang, bing. 2 months later, we signed to Def Jam, and we got a single out. And you know what I mean? Like, just fans.
How was you feeling when you got that Nick thing hookup? How were you feeling?
Yeah, I was feeling like I was on top of the world, bro. Like, it was a lot of fun. And you know what I mean? The buzz and getting fans for the first time and everything, and really getting a project together and stuff. But, you know, now we got new stuff going on.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Okay.
Right on, man. Well, shout out to Nick Cannon, man. Doing sure. big things. Always been doing big things. It's an old friend of mine, and I've watched him grow, so I'm glad he's taking care of you.
That's yeah.
what's up. Yeah. So what do you feel like is going to separate you from, like, the other ones, like Chris Brown, all these young artists? What do you think is going to make you a little... Let make you stand
different.
Out?
Different? Mm-hmm. I like that. Thank you. I don't feel like a lot of people ask me that question. Yeah. Actually, because... I was raised in Chicago, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then from there, I went to Louisiana. From Louisiana, I went to Miami. And then from Miami, I went to... And that was all in the span of, like, 8 years.
Mm-hmm.
And then from when I was 8, I moved to Trinidad and Tobago. And I stayed there for, like, 7 years.
No,
so,
like, okay, I was like, wow.
Yeah, so I was with my moms and my grandma and my auntie and everything. And I learned a totally different culture. Like, the music's different. The food's different. You know, people are different out
mm-hmm.
there. So it kind of gave me a different outlook on life, mm-hmm. pretty much, and like the way that I act. And
so your music has got a little bit of that influence.
It versus, has a little bit, yeah.
Versus exactly. your standard R&B. Exactly. Okay, gotcha.
Exactly. So you might hear some little words here and there that might set me apart. Like in my single, Real Lovin', that I just released like a week ago, 2 weeks ago, mm-hmm. I say, and you ain't gotta act like I'm moving left, mm-hmm. which means you ain't gotta act like I'm being weird with you or nothing, you know mm-hmm. what I mean? Like,
yeah. So that's a slang.
That's a slang, gotcha. Exactly. Okay. So little things like that, they're gonna be like, did he just say moving left?
What does that
like,
mean?
What does that mean?
Okay, yeah. You got some nice little pipes there. Sing a little something for us live real quick.
Oh, yo, Rolling
Crone. Give us a little concert. Give us something we're going to look forward to.
We in here now. It's been a long time coming. This a new day now. So I'm going to make you feel something. And you ain't never got to worry. This love gon' be poppin', you know what I mean. And I won't ever be in a hurry. Already told you that I'm down for life. Yeah, baby.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Can we get a round of applause for the
Sounds
young man
good,
there?
Brother.
Hey. Yay.
Hey. I appreciate it.
Yeah. All right. So what did we bring? What did you bring that we can play real quick?
This is actually my single, Real Lovin', that I was just saying I released like 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
So it's actually going to be, the free download is going to be finishing at the end of this month. So you have 10 days left to get the free download.
Okay.
The music video for it is coming out on November 10th. And then it's going on iTunes November 18th, I believe. So that's
where we, okay, cool.
Can we play a little something?
Yeah, for sure. Better believe it. I'm all yours. Yeah. We in here now. It's been a long time coming. This a new day now. So I'ma make you feel something. And you ain't never gotta worry. This love gon' be popping, you know what I mean. And I won't ever be in a hurry. Already told you that I'm down for life, yeah, baby. You ain't gotta act slow in a rush. Cause I love it, baby, when you hold my love. You ain't gotta hold my back. Cause baby, I'm gonna love you.
All right. Okay, yeah, that sounds like some real
groovy,
R&B
man.
Music.
Nah, that's groovy, man.
That sounds like some real R&B music.
Now, and that's what I like. See, I can rock to that.
The Neos and that type of music. And you've actually worked with Neo, right?
Actually, I did a show with him at the Hard Rock Cafe in New York. And that was like...
Yeah, shout out to Neo. He's a friend of the show. We love Neo.
We're gonna have him on
that's what
point.
We like. We like. And look, what I like about you is you actually sound like the song. Like live.
Oh yeah. You strong, man. You sound good. So you do the record justice.
Most people give them a little test and they ain't quite right.
Sound nothing like that,
in real life, right?
They don't quite sound like the track.
That don't sound like what we just had.
like you a dirty lie. That's not you. Yeah. That's not you. I don't like it.
Yeah. So I mean, definitely, like that's like meeting with Neo in New York. That was just like amazing. Now I would love to work with him. Mm-hmm. So if you could definitely try to hit that up, you know.
He said a quick shout out. Neo, you heard that. If you're paying attention, young man want to work with you. And now I saw you have a song called Dirty Girl.
Oh yeah.
Now what does that mean?
It's actually a dance.
All right. I know you a young and tender.
She old, so you gotta help her out with those kind of things. She don't know what no dirty girl is.
Actually I released that when I did I released Dirty Girl before I released Spending All My Time. So when we released that one, I was 17. So it's not, I can't even.
Okay. Well, how old are you now, Young and Tender?
I'm 19. Young and Tender. young and tender, fresh. You're so fresh with yourself. when I was 17, I released Dirty Girl. And that was just like pretty much a dance where, you know what I mean? Like it was like a Caribbean feeling song, like where people could get dirty if you want to.
Right.
But it was really a dance. Like if you watch
like slow whining.
Right. You could do that if you want, but that's your choice.
Got you. Okay. Well, we're going to take a little break. If you want to call in and chit-chat with Aaron Fresh, you can call in at 323-247-7443, and we'll be right back with the Relationship Dish of the Show.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah. Hey, LA, are you getting out to vote on Tuesday, November 6th? I know I am. This is Lady J of Lady J's Wild World of Sports, and I'm joining my family right here, LA Talk Live, and encouraging the citizens of Los Angeles to get out and vote on Election Day. As you know, this is one of the most important elections in our American history, and we need everyone in LA to register and have a voice on November 6th. Currently, the state of California, the state we live in, has 6.5 million people eligible but not registered to vote. And about half of those voters live in LA County. So I'm joining the family here at LA Talk Live and encouraging you to register and vote on Tuesday, November 6th. And if you haven't yet registered, don't worry. You have until midnight on October 22nd, and you can now even register online. So there is no excuse. That's right. If you have a signature filed online with DMV or a state ID number, you can now register to vote at registertovote.ca.gov. And don't forget to join us here on Tuesday, November 6th for LA Get Out and Vote, our live Election Day coverage from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m., where we're going to keep you tuned in exclusively to LA election news and poll coverage all day right here on my station, LA Talk Live, where we are more than just talk. Okay? What up, what up, what up? And we are back in the building. We got Aaron Fresh sitting in with us today. If you missed the first part of talking with him, you are more than welcome to call in at 323-247-7443 and holler at the young boy. But right now, we're about to break off into the SHS relationship dish. And we're going to chat with you a little bit about your social life here, young and tender. we need to know what's going on in your world.
Man, in my world.
Actually, you know what? We got a caller. Somebody got a question for Young Fresh. Hey, you're on the air.
Hello?
Yes.
Who are we speaking? Am I talking to LA Live?
Yes, you are. Okay, do you have a question for anybody, for Aaron?
Okay, I'm trying not. I'm trying not to scream right now.
You're what?
I need to believe a freaking person.
I don't understand what's happening.
You need to breathe for a second? Is that what you said?
Oh, okay. Well, when you breathe, get breathing, call back.
Call back.
All right. next caller.
I love you.
I love you.
We're sorry. He loves you. But he loves you. Sweetie, we got to keep it going.
Next caller. You got another one?
Yeah. Hey, what up? You're on the air with Aaron Fresh. What's going on? Y'all going to get y'all call life together. I promise. That's what you're going to do. Call in when you are ready to speak. Another one?
No.
What up, what up, what up? You're on the air with Aaron Fresh.
Hello?
Yes.
Oh, snap.
Okay, my love. Okay. Hey, you're on the air. This is Staci Harris Show with Aaron Fresh. What's up?
Hey, is it Avery?
Yes.
Hi, Avery. What's going on? You got a question for Aaron?
Yes, I was wondering, I have two, actually. If you wasn't a singer, what would you be doing right now?
If I wasn't a singer, what would I be? I mean, I've always wanted to be a singer, so I really can't see myself doing anything else.
I understand that.
Nothing. Nothing.
Yes.
Okay, my second question is, when you was a child, did you have anything that you look back now and laugh at?
Did I have anything
that you look back at and laughed at as a child?
So. Oh, yeah, definitely. I don't know if I could really say it because it's kind of
incriminating.
It's kind of incriminating.
Image. Yeah. It ain't a good look for your image.
But pretty much it ended up with me getting a spanking because I did something that I wasn't supposed to do by the pool. And my
you didn't boo boo in the pool, did you?
Nah.
You did the number one.
You ain't boo boo in the pool.
That wasn't it.
Nigga's face. You sure?
Somehow I don't believe that.
It wasn't fresh. It wasn't fresh. I'm not going to say nothing. Wes, you got to stop it. Wesley.
Okay. Well, thank you for your call. Next caller. No more. Okay. There it is. Is that somebody? What up? You on live with Staci Harris Show. Talk to Aaron Fresh. What's up?
Hey, what's up? This is Kimmy.
What up?
Hi, Kimmy.
Oh, my gosh. This is one of my top fans right here.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, Kimmy's always been there from the beginning. What's good, Kimmy?
Hey, Aaron. So my question is, you can collab with anybody right now. Who would it be with?
If I could collab with anybody right now, who would it be with?
Good question.
I want to say it would be Rihanna.
Rihanna.
Why?
Why?
Because, number one, because she's beautiful.
Yeah,
number
yeah.
two, we got the same birthday. Number three, we're from the Caribbean.
There so, you go. That's hey. That's a match made in heaven right there.
There you go.
Shout outs to Rihanna. Yes, you yes. heard him. Make his dream come true.
All right. Well, I'll talk to you guys later.
Bye, all right. Kimmy. Thanks for calling. Is it? Yeah. All right. Okay. Well, Aaron is hot today.
Yeah.
Hot tamale.
What up, you all on the air of the Staci Harris Show? Holla at Aaron Fresh.
Oh, hi. My name's Alicia. What's oh, my gosh. I can't believe I'm on the air. Hi, Aaron.
How you doing, Alicia?
Okay, so my question is, how does your music career affect your school?
How does my music career affect school? Actually,
like your schooling education.
Well, as of right now, because I'm out of high school and I actually finished my high school education, right now I've just been really honing in on getting this project together that I'm not even in college right now. Like, if I was in regular life, I would be in college right now. So, you know, it kind of just affected that right now. So,
it doesn't. Yeah. It's not affecting it.
Okay, that's cool.
I'm not in school. Basically, I'm not in school.
Yeah.
All right,
that's cool.
Thanks for calling.
Thank you for calling.
You're welcome. Bye.
Bye.
It's cute.
We good? We got anything else?
One more.
All right. Hot commodity over here. What up? You on live with the Staci Harris Show? Talk to Aaron Fresh.
Hello, my name is Stephanie. Hey, Aaron.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm good. I'm good. At the LA Talk Live show.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. My question is for me and Kimmy Almighty.
Okay.
Do you love grits and bacon?
Hysterical.
Oh, my gosh. Do I love grits and bacon? Actually, I am so in love with grits and bacon. Like, on some
that's
real
so
stuff.
Hysterical.
No, like.
Like, what randomness?
I know it's random.
What randomness is that?
It is random, but actually.
Do you like sugar on your grits?
I do like bacon and grits. I can't lie. My godmother would make it for me all the time when I was living in Louisiana. So.
Yeah. Lovely. I love that. Yes, I love grits and bacon as well.
Cool.
Well, there you go.
All right,
grits
all right.
and bacon. Yeah. Grits and bacon.
Well, thank you for calling and acting his breakfast needs. Thank you. Is that it?
One more.
All right, hot all boy. Right. What up? You were on the air, the Staci Harris Show. Holla at Aaron Fresh.
Do you like sugar on your grits?
Hello?
Oh, that's the playback. What's up? What's up? You gotta turn your radio down in the background. We can we hear ourselves. Yeah, can hello?
Better.
Oh. Okay, you might want to call back when you get your life together in the background. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Okay. All right. Well, you can get back to the phone calls a little later. We got to actually talk to the boy. 323-247-7443. I will open it up for phone calls in a little bit later. He will be here, I promise. Okay.
Stay stupid.
All right. So, let's chop it up about your since everybody is all the girls, because not one there male has called to talk to you. So let's talk
which
about.
Which is all right.
No, that's great.
Which
that's
is
great.
All right.
That's
I
great.
Am not mad at that.
I'm
that's great. That says your target
either.
Audience is please.
Yes.
That's what it says. So as far as relationships go, have you been in one?
Nah. I mean, nah. No. I can't.
Yet.
Yeah, I can't even say that I've been in a relationship.
Like, so
I've
you've never had a heartbreak, like a
never
real
been
one
in love
that kicked
yet.
Your chest in and went all the way through
yeah,
the back
you
of
even
your
had
back?
Like a girl just take your heart and tap dance on it and stomp
with
it
stilettos.
And throw it out the window, pick it up and burn it and
all that. You ain't never had that. Look at us. Oh, look at you. Ain't never
yeah,
had that
you
hurt.
That bitter hurt. That hurt is stings so bad you can't eat. You can't sleep.
Not really. I haven't had it that bad, because that does sound pretty bad.
Trust me, it's worse.
It gets worse, huh?
I wish it upon no one.
Oh, boy, Wesley, you need it. Okay. All right.
It's bad, brother. It's bad.
I've never really had that, you know what I mean? But
you will.
I definitely have.
Oh, you will.
Look at him. You will.
There will be blood.
There will be blood.
Oh, man.
I'm just saying, you're going to have at least one or two heartbreaks.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to hurt, too.
And you know, you can't get through life without it, man. Let me tell you. I think that's probably the most... That is your true initiation into manhood. Believe me, it is, man.
That's my bar mitzvah?
Yes, man. That's your bar mitzvah, for sure.
And it's the woman's sanity breaking point. It's what turns all women crazy when they had that first heartbreak. Mm. Gone.
Okay, y'all making me scared right now. But check this out. I can't stand y'all right now. Look, I actually have had, relationships where I feel like I probably use that as... fuel for my music, inspiration.
Yeah, right.
You know
what
I mean, like, even like real loving, like I go back to a time where I was actually like liking somebody in my life, and you know, it kind of blossoms from there. If there's a breakup song that I'm doing, it kind of just makes it more intense, you know what I mean? It puts that soul into it.
Mm-hmm.
So I can say that I have had relationships, but not like a...
Not there. Not
like,
yeah.
Hey,
man. You dated a few little things here and there.
Yeah, I mean, you know what I'm saying?
In other words, you have dated, but you haven't given anybody that beat in your chest yet.
That's what I'm trying to get to.
Okay, well, as long as you can't hold out on that beat, keep that beat inside your chest for your chest. Because once you give it to the girl that's going to break it...
Yeah.
Tell you, end up be the same.
Y'all sound like y'all need to write a song and go sing.
Y'all need to go sing. Let some of that out.
You know what it's called? The blues.
The blues.
You ignorant.
Yeah. That's what it's called. Me and Stace, boy.
It's good.
Yeah.
It's called the blues. We gonna keep it all the way 100. It's called the blues. Dirty blues.
That sounds horrible, guys.
So you haven't been tainted by love. No heartbreak. Anybody want to date Aaron and not break his heart? Call in at 323-247-7443. Now, have you been on tours or doing anything like that, as far as like
opening up for anybody or yeah?
So you have experienced the groupie factor then?
I have. I can't even try to go around it. But it was because when Spinning on My Time came out, Baby by Justin Bieber had just came out. Oh. We were on the same label.
Okay.
So
two little young and tenders.
Exactly. Two little young and tenders.
Singing about that love.
Mm-hmm. But we both Justin was inside the stadium, and Def Jam put together a Teen Island Fan Fest tour with me and a few other artists right outside the stadium, where I would close the show. Actually, after two shows, they were like, Aaron, we need you to close the show. I was like, chia.
We'll do.
And I would do it well.
Right.
I ended up closing the show. And man, it just the love that I used to get out there, man, it was just amazing. Going on 11, 15 cities tour with Justin Bieber, of course, and like people was actually coming on our bus, like asking, "Yo, is Justin on there?" I was like, "I'm Aaron."
But, he's not, but I am.
So exactly. Basically, you got Justin's groupies left, though. Is that you saying?
No. I did. That's where it blossomed from, though. That's where I got my.
So you have experienced the groupies.
Yes, for me. Yeah. For Aaron Fresh,
the
yes,
desperate
I have.
Smelling girls, huh?
Yeah, they sweet.
They sweet.
Smell like nachos.
They smell like nachos.
Smell like nachos and bacon and grits.
And now ladies and all that. I know. Okay. Well, Wesley J, are you ready to break into why do people think it's
segment?
Okay?
Oh, yeah. My segment. Boy. I have a segment, man. I call it Why Do People Think It's Okay? And actually, it's perfect because I'm sure you've experienced some of these things. why do people think it's okay?
Why do people think it's okay
to ask you how you got your start in the business, in the entertainment business, in a loud, crowded, busy environment where you got people tugging and pulling at you, you're signing autographs, you're trying to make sure people look. Here's the thing. Basically, how is it that someone can ask you a question that's like, that requires a lifelong answer. Right. You dig what I'm saying? So like
you're an interview like this.
It's a therapy session.
Yeah, it's quiet. We can hear each other. You're not, you know, I can't, but when you're asking somebody, you know, how'd you get started in the business? And you got to go back and tell them, well, when I was 8, you got this loud and everybody's tugging at you. It's just kind of annoying. So it's like,
it's not okay.
It's not okay to do. You know, it's not the time or place to do that. It's just not, it's loud. Mm-mm. All right, next. Why do people think it's okay to see someone who is famous, recognizable, walking down the street, and that famous, recognizable person is 100 yards away when you decide you want to scream out and stop them for a picture or autograph, and they in a rush?
You don't like it?
No, I don't like it.
Is that okay?
And have the audacity to tell the person that you want to take a picture with them to come back and walk this green mile distance to take a pic that you have requested. Now hold on. Now,
did you say a green mile distance, you nut?
That's a green mile.
Now, it's like, it's kind of like this. Now, ladies, you guys can relate to this. When a brother,
I'm not gonna do it.
No. When a brother says, you know, sees you walking down the street and he want to talk to you, want to holler, and you say, "Hey, yo, Ma, come here." Come here. You want to talk to her, brother. You got to go to her.
That's right.
So if you're requesting something from somebody, don't expect them to, you know, this is personal.
And they want to get an attitude when you don't want to come over there and take a picture.
Get mad.
You know what? I actually,
are you paying for this?
I have had that. Now you think, oh my gosh, I feel.
And they're like, Aaron, come.
Hey man, I was the one that was like, me, okay, I'm coming, okay.
Oh, you went over there.
You went over there.
Hey, look, it was my first time.
Impressed. Like I said, it's new. That's why it's new. I did it too.
It was new to me and everything, yep. So I was like, okay, let's do it. And they was popping attitudes and all of this.
Yeah,
right, man.
It's a trip, right?
It is a trip.
It's crazy, man. It's like, you know, you figure it's like, dude, I've already walked down this far, but you want me to turn around and come back when it's like, why don't you just.
But you know what that shows, though? That shows that we're humble enough to go back to them. And, you know what I mean?
Do it.
Oh, give them a clap for that. That's nice.
That's what it is, though.
You keep that attitude. We got a caller.
I got one more, though, before we take that call. Let me do one more. All right.
Y'all got a call back.
These ones just happened to me. This is why I'm saying it. All right. Why do people think it's okay to blast you out after following them on Twitter? Now, what I'm saying is this. Now, check this out. Right? I mean, if you want to thank me, for instance, if you follow somebody and you didn't say anything, I just followed you, so they get that notification that you were followed.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Why must you get on the computer and then type, "Thank you, Aaron Fresh, for following me," and blast it? I know you're trying to show out and show off, but you could have just thanked me in DM. That's why I just followed you. You could have direct messaged me that and said, "Hey, thank you."
What's the fun of that? They want everybody to know that.
But see, in some ways, a shape or form, and that's a light subject. You might be following somebody you ain't supposed to be following. You don't want nobody to follow. You know I'm gonna turn it into that.
See, that go back to you got dirt, you dirty nigga. You got some dirt. You boy, try.
You dirty. Woman, I ain't want nobody to know I'm following you. Damn. And even if it's not that, like, say this is a big booty girl, right? It's a big booty girl, just distasteful Abby, right? But you sit there and say, okay, I'm a follower anyway. Don't know what. She's going to say, thank you for following me. And everybody know I'm following the big booty triple X girl.
The nastiest
picture in the world. It's not okay. Stop blasting me out.
Hey, look, if he didn't DM you after the follow, don't do that. If he didn't send you a personal private message, do not blast my Yona's life.
You don't do that. You don't do it.
All right.
That why do people think it's okay? And that concludes my segment of why do people think it's okay.
Hey, but at the end of the day, it is promotion.
No, it is. Say my name.
Right. Exactly. We always ask this question to our guests. What's a deal breaker for in dating somebody? What's a deal breaker? Something you will not tolerate,
like a pet peeve or something that's just like you.
Man, I feel like after a while, if you just start being really like oh my god, like kind of ditzy, like the world is
like if they're not quite
up to par,
if they're not,
like there was one mentally? Girl, like let me tell you, like one time I was in high school a year ago
hysterical.
When I was in high school, like there's this one girl that was just like always working out, and like, you know, I mean, I get that we're on the same track team and that's lovely, you're in shape and that's awesome, but at the end of the day, when it's time to sit down and do our homework. And
she want to do push-ups.
She want to do like splits and stuff and start stretching and stuff. Like, we are finished with running. It's time to do homework now. You know what I mean? So, I mean, you know, spoiled.
You know who you are. It was just a year ago. Get your life together. Get your life together. You cannot do push-ups and sit-ups in homework time. It's not cute. Men don't want a woman stronger than them.
No, we don't.
So if you were challenging Aaron, you just lost. You lost.
No, we don't.
That's why y'all ain't together. Okay, so so you don't want the ditzy kind of, or the challenge, like don't want to one up me.
Yeah, you don't want the woman that's always trying to compete with you.
No, I like competition. Don't get me wrong. Yeah. I love competition. That's
what kind of competition?
Cool. No, that's cool. Like, you know, like, what I mean, like, give me a challenge.
Like basketball, no shooting. That's, you said you don't what?
I don't want a man try to upstage me.
Why?
Because that's not what we do. It's friendly. We're supposed to be together.
So he's supposed to, what, page. lose when you guys are playing like games, like pool or shooting the basketball?
You want
to
stay with me? Lose.
No mercy. I'm going to pummel you to the ground, and I'm going to talk about you. You lost.
I think that's the best.
Thing men are really competitive. We don't care. We're gonna I'll be the little kid. Video games. Sorry, you little bastard. You lost. You lost. I got you. Finish him.
Crying, self esteem just went down into the hole, and you standing over him.
No one's
mommy
there.
Never lets the babysit my children. They will have high self esteem. You will not be at Uncle Wesley's house.
I'm beating my kids too. I'm gonna play Mortal Kombat with my kids at some point, and I'm gonna beat them down. And he's gonna get mad.
You gonna beat
him
down?
I'm gonna beat him down in the game. He's gonna be mad at you.
Toughen him up. Get him ready for these streets.
I feel like when it comes to women though, there are some instances where you have to let them win. There are some stuff.
What instances?
Like,
give me one. So I don't know how
like
to do it next
time.
If
we were playing a game, like if we were playing ping pong or something.
Mm-hmm. You let her win?
I would let her win because, I mean, especially if we're in front of friends and stuff.
Okay.
That's when you're in front of friends.
Friends, let her win.
Let her win. And she can be like, oh my God, give me a hug. Yeah.
Looking for the reward. See, he's looking for the reward.
And I won at that point. Right.
And I won at that point. Okay. It was gratifying to me.
Gave me some game. All
right. That's right.
I'll try that.
But that's the whole Aaron Precious gave Rusty J some game.
When everybody leaves. That's when we're gonna play again.
Then you can get to,
then you're gonna see what's up.
Really, what's up?
You're gonna see where I'm at.
Exactly. I don't appreciate the turn that you just made. I don't appreciate that.
I'm just
turn.
Saying, I gotta
love
like
it.
That. I didn't like that turn. Did we like that?
Yes,
I didn't like the turn.
Did.
I like that.
Tam, did you find out about that story? No.
No good.
Well, I'm gonna shout this story out anyway, just because we don't know where it came from.
Maybe somebody else can help.
But before we transition into the last segment of the show, there was on
Instagram
there was a picture posted of a man who literally had chunks of flesh that looked like they had been like hacked out of his back.
Yeah.
Like literally, you could see his meat and everything. The caption read, "This is what happens when your girlfriend comes home and finds you having sex with her 8-year-old son."
Yeah, that's wrong.
So, a little shout out to the molesters. Get your gang together because somebody is going to take your life.
Yes.
And did they go too far? No.
No.
You lucky you didn't have your heart sitting next to you. That's some stuff you do not do. You do not mess with somebody's child. And look at Breisha Webb.
You knew you was going to hear it.
You going to walk in here late, but you look cute.
You look great.
You look great.
Well, I try.
Let's welcome Breisha Webb to the half mark of the show.
Yeah. Well, thank you.
Yeah. Breisha Webb, this is Aaron Fresh. He's a singer up and coming.
Oh, well, hello. You look all cute and Chris Brownie.
Oh, gosh. Chris Brownie. Thank
you. We've been talking to Young and Tender. He got a lot of little female fans been calling in.
I saw him on Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, somebody was like, "Oh my goodness, you so cute."
Hey, hey, I ain't mad at that.
What can he say?
It's
my mother's.
It's
hysterical. It's my mother.
Yeah.
We're going to take a little break before we go into the next segment of the show. We will be right back in a few minutes with Aaron Fresh, Wesley J, Breisha Webb, and Lil' O' Meat.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm addicted to the fast life, going metro, keep it 100, all I know. If you ain't talking about paper, then you ain't talking about none. Yeah, I came from the bottom, now I'm working with some. Fast life, going metro, keep it 100.
Hi, LA. Are you getting out to vote on Tuesday, November 6th? I know I am. Hi, this is Julie Orlov of Pathways to Love, and I'm joining LA Talk Live in encouraging the citizens of Los Angeles to get out and vote on Election Day. As you know, this is one of the most important elections in our American history, and we need everyone in LA to register and have a voice on November 6th. Currently, the state of California has 6.5 million people eligible but not yet registered to vote, and about half of those voters live in LA County. So I'm joining the family here at LA Talk Live in encouraging you to register and vote on Tuesday, November 6th. And if you haven't yet registered, don't worry, you have until midnight, October 22nd, and you can now even register online. That's right, if you have a signature file online with the DMV or a state ID number, you can now register to vote at registertovote.ca.gov. And don't forget to join us here on Tuesday, November 6th for LA Get Out and Vote, our live Election Day coverage from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m., where we are going to keep you tuned in exclusively to LA election news and poll coverage all day right here on LA Talk Live, where we are more than just talk.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Miss Margot Hudson and the hottest new love and relationship radio show,
Destination Love Life, where love and wellness come together as one.
Every Monday at 10 a.m.
Join us as we give the latest in love advice,
tips,
interviews,
news,
call-ins,
games,
and giveaways,
exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream. Use your Android phone, iPhone, iPad, whatever you have, prepaid, BlackBerry, let's do it.
Destination Love Life, every Monday, 10 a.m. Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure.
We are more than just talk.
Health, love, healing, laughter.
The Margot Hudson Way, every Monday, 10 a.m. Ooh, right in your ear hole.
Ooh, Rob, I like your brain.
I've never heard nobody say they want to suck on my intelligence.
Crazy. We'll see you there, everybody.
We used to live in the same building on the same floor, and never met before until I'm overseas on tour. And Pete, this Ethiopian queen from Philly taking classes abroad. She's studying film and photo flash focus.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Says she's working on a flick and cut my click.
Yeah, go for
it. She loved my show in Paris, had Elise Momar, and that I stepped off the stage and took a piece of her heart. We knew from the start that things fall apart, intent to shatter. She like that shit don't matter when I get home. Get out of through that phone, whatever.
Oh, we got a little baby singing.
You missed the crumb.
We let him close out a little summer of the song. You let him croon. You know what croon mean, young and tender? You know what croon mean?
Crooning it.
Wait, what?
You know what crooning mean? Crooning.
Crooning.
K-R-O-O-N-I-N-G.
Crooning when you croon.
When you croon.
Oh, you is a young
look
and
up,
tender.
Look up Nat King Cole.
Yeah, when you croon.
Look up Sam Cooke.
Okay.
That's what they call when they
basically croon is an old slang word for singing.
You're singing and you're singing to the ladies, getting to the soul of
crying too. I might have to make that ingrained.
Teddy Pendergrass. That's croon.
That'll set you away from these little young boys.
Croon. Set you far apart.
Gosh, you guys put me on.
Get your crooning you up on, young and tender.
Season you up a little bit. Some of that Lowry sauce.
Yeah, that Lowry.
Some of that Lowry.
Put that Lowry on him. Mm-hmm. What up? We are back in the building. We got Aaron Fresh and we got Miss Breisha Webb, who decided to join us.
Just 30 minutes late. Just tardy for the party.
Amazingly 30 minutes. I mean, what is 30 minutes?
alive, you know. God bless.
And real quick, that story I just told you about, it actually is true. It happened in 2009, though. It was an Atlanta coach who went to the lady house to encourage the young 8-year-old boy to join the sports and tried to get some. I don't know where you are, but I hope you burn in a fiery hell, you dirty nigga. All right.
Amen.
Right.
Go ahead.
All right, so we're actually really getting close to the last segment of the show, and it is called
Fail.
And I like to talk about everything I think is failing. Let's talk about it.
Let's talk.
Well, that guy who got chunks out of it.
That was a smooth fail, right?
And the smooth fail. That was rugged.
And the fail was the mama because she didn't kill him.
She didn't finish the job.
Did she go to jail?
I don't know if she went to jail, but I hope not.
I wouldn't think so.
I hope somebody gave her a medal.
I think so. I hope so.
I hope they gave her a medal.
Listen, there's things that happen all over this world that is probably that much intense or even worse.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I've seen and heard some. I've heard some stories when I was living in Trinidad, just for instance, where some kids did some really bad stuff to a young individual, like a 9-year-old, and it just involved a lot of gruesome stuff, and we ended up singing, like, there was a song by Fantamoja, right?
Oh,
a big man like you, was like, no, baby. Like, it's like,
hey,
really, no. It was really intense, and, like, there's little things like that where, I feel like, you want to get them back, but even, like, when I went to church today with my PR and my mom, it was just, like, about forgiveness and stuff.
Oh, yeah, you definitely have to forgive, because that, if it's for you, it's not for, forgiveness is for you, not for the other person, but before you forgive, go ahead and send them somewhere.
Leave something to remember you by.
Yeah, I'll work on the forgiving. In the meantime, while I work on forgiving, I'm
going to slice your back.
I'm going to give them something.
Leave them something to remember you by.
Oh, man. That's a fail.
That is an epic fail. So, ladies, you epic. You all loud in the bag. Let me get epic. All right, so this is my first fail. People who blame everyone else for their failure. That's a fail.
It is.
Ain't nobody responsible for your life and the things you did not do or are still trying to do and have not accomplished. Don't look over here. Don't ask me what is wrong with your life. That is a fail. I don't want to. Hey, get your life together.
Right, but sometimes they need assistance, you know? Maybe they need
They're blaming. See, I don't like when they blame everybody else for why their life ain't together.
Oh, yeah. They need a Yana Van Zandt in there.
Yeah,
life.
You need to sit down with Oprah on her couch and let her give you that life training or whatever she do. And you let Oprah tell you. You listen to Oprah. Oprah's successful. I listen to Oprah. I was. That's a fail. Shout out to Oprah. Don't blame anybody else for your problem. Being a grandma in the club and have the nerve to be an aggressive grandma, that's a fail.
A grandma?
A grandma in the club.
In the club, two-stepping with these young children.
Yeah.
Being aggressive, trying to holler at the young children. But you're not a MILF. You a grandma. Like you got your babies in
the
backseat. The
reason why she's saying this is because this is what we witnessed.
I mean,
really?
Wesley J had a birthday party last night.
What?
I'm going to just put them on.
Yeah, put it out there.
Wesley J had a birthday party last night at the Biltmore. And it was Social Security in there for some of them. Like, they was collecting checks. And you in there trying to get with Wesley and hug his little waist. He don't want to see him.
Hey, grandmamas need love too.
I mean, that's but the aggressive thirst that was displayed.
It was just
displayed throughout the party. Low key made me say, okay, let's round up the grandmas and take them back to the home. This is too much. I mean, and just
fail.
Oh, giving you the ugly face just.
And
I know you want it,
Wesley. Wesley don't want that. He don't want that.
No way, Wesley.
I believe.
How did you feel?
Hey man, look, it's love is love.
It was a great age range, though. I'll say that it was like from young people all the way to grandma's in there.
So I could have gone there too.
Actually,
could have.
Well, if you would have walked in, you would have.
If I was with Wesley,
yeah.
But they would have carded you otherwise, and then young and tender, you wouldn't have made it.
Yeah.
I would have made it. I'd be like, I am a singer. I deserve some respect. Okay.
Aw, he's so cute.
Nah, I probably would have failed.
Yeah.
Failed. Right. This is another fail I don't like. This happened to me recently. When we out in the streets, event, party, whatever, and you want to holler, don't walk up and spout off your resume to me.
Oh, Lord.
Don't you walk up to me and give me a rundown from 1999 to the current 2012.
Of what you've accomplished.
Mm-hmm. Don't do that. Yeah,
yeah. Because that all of a sudden it will take your ugly away.
Yeah, because now I'm thinking.
I don't need that.
Because that's going to make you attractive. Mm-hmm. Yep. See, but that's what y'all think. Y'all think if you walk up here, because you already know, you probably got a shot. So what happens is, I'm just being honest. I'm very blunt. What happens is you from across the room, you said, do target. There she is.
Yeah.
So they reevaluate themselves and they said, I ain't going to cut it. So. But what they knew was they had some success in their life.
Yeah, yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
so, so they say she probably likes success.
Yeah. So I'm going to give her my success story. Here.
And instead of saying, hi, my name is, I'm going to say, hi, I used to work with da-da-da-da-da-da.
So, yeah.
You know.
You know.
Don't do that. You know, I don't want to hear it. Because I'm at an event right now. I don't even want to talk to you, first of all. But right now, I'm at an event. So if you want to run your resume off, you invite me to lunch and feed me while you run off your resume.
That makes sense.
I'm just saying.
Not over this loud music that I'm struggling with.
Right.
You know, like I said,
I'm just saying, entertain my belly while you try to entertain yourself. I don't want to do it.
So do you just walk away? Or do you just like...
No, I kind of get rude sometimes. And I can see that. Yeah. Yeah.
So I can see that.
You seeing it?
I can see that.
Sometimes I can be really disrespectful. I can. It is not. Somebody's going to bust me in my eye one time. I promise they are. They're going to smack me right in my mouth. Some dude is going to put his hands on me. I know it is. But I try, the older I get, to not be as disrespectful as I used to when I was younger. Just
cooperate,
reckless.
Cooperate.
Yeah, I could be nice. Yeah.
You know what you should do? So? You should just give them the nice hard nod. Mm-hmm.
It's okay. Just,
mm-hmm. Yes, well, mm-hmm. They get that. Like, and you look around. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Or you could just, like, use the music and be like, huh?
What's to do that?
I do that.
Do the yin yang twins.
I choose to be disrespectful and rude because you'll never do it to nobody else. You will remember the terror that happened. When
don't you do that again.
When I was so disrespectful to you. So the next time you see a girl, you'll be like, I ain't going to do that to her. She ain't going to give me.
Fail.
Fail.
That's an epic fail.
Fail.
Aaron, do you have a fail?
I don't usually fail. Nah.
I like that.
Because you know.
I don't mean have you failed.
I mean, do you have a fail of things that you think are failing?
The things you think are
like. Like what I just said about everybody?
Yeah. Oh, I see what you're saying. Oh, okay. I see what you're saying. Not that I could think of right now. Yeah. No. I really feel like I've been so secluded from the world because I've been like just really focusing on my like my project and stuff. I don't have time for all of that extra stuff. Yeah. Like there is no failing. Like I only look for success in my career, so that's it. Right. Like I could see like if a girl came up to me, like I said, and she want to work out instead of doing homework, like that's fail. A fail. That's a fail. Like stuff. I mean, little stuff like that. Like if you're gonna, especially women that like because you see my success, that's a fail.
Yeah, that's a fail.
Like if I don't talk about my success and you're telling me about my success, remember when you did spending on my time?
That's a good fail.
That's a good fail.
Like I was there. I remember when I did it.
I was there. I was singing all the notes.
I'm just saying.
Have you had some girls come back to you that maybe dissed you when you was in school?
Oh,
and they now see that you popping, got 108,000 followers on Twitter.
I love those stories. Good.
And now they tweeting you trying to get your number and things. Hey, if you turned down Aaron back in the past, call him. We want to talk to you.
Well, I'm not gonna name no names, but
he wanna talk to you.
Actually, I remember I was on a radio station one time, and a girl called me, like literally called me while I was at the radio station, and it was like, oh yeah, give us the number. I was like, okay, cool. Next thing you know, she's invited me to come to prom with her. Like, do you want to come to prom with me? And da 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 da. And I was like, ain't you the same chick that I told that I liked you, and you were saying some other story that I can't remember right now. Like, but you know, it's all good. I ain't even tripping. We still talk though. Actually, I saw her the other day.
Nice. You're nice.
You're really nice.
No, I mean, we don't talk like on a regular basis, but if I see you, I'm gonna say what's up.
Yeah,
your mother raised you right.
Shout out to mom.
Shout out to
raising
you
right.
Right. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
I'm not gonna. Yeah.
That's nice. That's really lovely.
I can't. Let her. Y'all look like that's nice. I would never do that.
No. To the left.
To the left.
Keep pushing.
Like I mean, we don't want to have nothing to talk about. I just feel like if you shame me, then your intentions are bad now, and I do not wish to have a communication with you. What do you want to talk to me about? Hmm? You want to come hang out in my VIP booth? I'm not going to let you do it. Security will kindly escort you out.
Yeah.
Nothing personal.
You ain't got to say it up front. Just be like, yeah, okay, be nice.
Yeah, call us.
Tell the security.
Okay. Well, if we got like a few more minutes left in the show. If you want to call in and talk to Young Freezy, Aaron Fresh, call in at 323-247-7443. I wanted to talk about something. It's actually kind of serious. I'm going to switch gears for a second.
Uh-oh.
One of my girlfriends recently experienced, this is actually a fail too, recently had an experience of racism, like a current one in 2012.
Yeah. It now, happens.
Okay. Well, you can call back when I finish this story. we appreciate you. Please call back. I'm just saying. I'm sorry. You. I don't mean to be rude.
I love you.
I just really want to tell the story.
it's real.
2012. Racism. My girl, she was going to, she was out in Eagle Rock, and she had to, something for work, meet the director or something for whatever, they were shooting something, but, she was out there, and, she was, I guess she was walking.
No, she was walking across the street.
And there was literally, like, a group of young, white, Caucasian men who decided to scream and chant a song that started with the N-word.
What?
Yes.
A rap song?
Nigga.
What?
I'm talking about, he said what? No, but like they were calling her a nigga, like, get out the way, nigga. And did a, like, like aggressively screaming out nigga, like that's what we, like we back in the slug, she getting drugged behind the truck. Like, we don't do that. What? Yeah. That is an epic fail. If you are still carrying racism and you never experienced it, we are in 2012. You didn't live in racist times.
Our president is black and my Lambo is blue. Come on, y'all.
They don't care about that. They do not care. So it's an epic fail for you to carry racism at 2012. In 2012, and you're probably like 20 years old, sitting there spouting that stuff up. You ain't never experienced a racist moment in your life.
Chill
and
out.
You calling somebody a nigga. Call me a nigga.
See what happened, right?
Oh, Lord.
Oh yeah, you do not want to do that to Stay.
That's so that really is disrespectful. Like in 2012, it is so. I mean, come on, yo. You've never experienced anything racist. Like your parents did, your grandparents did. You know what I'm saying? Like you don't even have reason to spout that.
Nobody's ever like been in the store and people feel like they're going. Around.
Yeah, I mean those.
You need help
when they follow you, but that blatant. Nigga spouting out. No. Who made you feel comfortable enough to do that in the streets of public?
Jay-Z, Kanye West. I mean, let's be real. We say it in all of our songs.
Yeah,
I mean, but to use it in that way
in that
awful.
Context. Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Exactly. All right, we have a caller.
We did. And we still have one.
They still there?
Yeah.
Oh, y'all still there? That's nice. Hey, what up? You on the air? Staci Harris Show. Holla at young boy Aaron Fresh. Huh? No?
Yeah, now.
Okay. Hey, what up? You on the air? The Staci Harris Show. Holla at the young boy Fresh. You got a question?
Hello? Did I seriously go through?
You were seriously through, Mama. Come on now.
Hey. Question. What inspired him to start singing?
What inspired me to start singing? I don't know. I've always kind of wanted to sing. Like, since I could ever remember, I actually had a Michael Jackson glove that I would take showers with and keep my hand outside while I took a shower.
Hysterical.
That is so funny.
You know
what I'm saying?
So,
just shining.
Yeah,
glowing.
Just let
so
it glow outside.
Didn't get washed.
It didn't get washed at all. And I had all the Michael Jackson DVDs and everything too. And then as time went on, I mean, it kind of went to Usher, to Stevie Wonder, because my mom, she would be playing all of that. She would be playing the Al Green's.
Mm-hmm. Ah, get it, boy. Get it, boy. What?
I'm so in love. And I'm playing.
With you.
I know, right? But,
that's
because
you know the classics.
Yeah, so she definitely helped me as well. And I just get my brother at the time, he was listening to Genuine and Usher and all of that. So I grew up listening to the NSYNCs and that whole
thing. Y'all go out in the background when you hear Genuine. Genuine had the baby hair.
Yeah, the baby hair.
Did you have baby hair?
My brother did though. Oh my God.
Oh, your brother had baby hair.
My brother had the little curls.
Aaron's brother had baby hair.
Curls,
I call him baby hair.
You put mousse and jam on it, just making a nice.
I used to literally try.
I bet you had
Michael
a swirl down your cheek.
I never did that. But
you
I did
take
do
the rat tail comb and try
Jackson,
to make a design.
Hold on, you know Michael Jackson had
you had the
curls. No, but mine wouldn't do it right. Like I would try to do it.
It wouldn't curl quite right.
It wouldn't go right, so the curl down and flip up and then be aimed out like this.
Wait, the curls do
it. Oh wait. Oh, we sorry, caller. Oh. Thank you so much. Oh, okay. We have a new caller. What up? You on the air with the Staci Harris Show, talking the air fresh. What's up?
Hello?
Yes. What's up? You on the air?
My question is for Aaron. I mean, I became a fan, like, over the summer. So I was, like, became a fan of all his old stuff. Also, how did he feel, like, not releasing songs from, like, 2010 to, like, now, before Real 11?
Yeah, the thing is, I am releasing music again. Like, I haven't released music in a while. I understand what you're saying. But, it feels good to be back releasing music now, you know what I mean? At the time, I don't know, I was just going through a lot with making music and stuff, so it feels good to be making music now and releasing new stuff and having this new project.
So in other words, he's always been releasing music.
That's right, I have been releasing music. So it just hasn't been on a broad spectrum, like spending all my time in a Dirty Girl. So, I mean, just keep on digging and you'll find some more music.
Thank you, caller.
Okay. One more question.
Oh, okay. Two questions.
Cool. Yes, go home.
Eric, can you say them to me in your Trinidadian accent?
You cut off.
Can I what?
There's something weird.
Trinidadian accent.
We're hearing something.
Wait, say it again.
What you want him to do?
Can you please say something in your Trinidadian accent?
Oh, she wants you to hear with that accent.
You want me to say something?
Drop some words with that accent.
All right. Well, right now we are the Staci, how you show with Wesley and Brisha. And we just chilling right now. My mom's here. My PR here. Got lovely ladies inside the room too. And I have a beautiful fan that's asking for some questions right now. So thanks.
Yeah, oh, man.
Did you enjoy that?
I did. Like, his accent is like the sexiest thing.
Thank you.
That's cute. Thanks for calling.
I love Trini.
We got another call.
I love me some Trini.
What up? Yeah. What up? What up? What up? You're on the air with the Staci Harris Show, talking to Aaron Fresh.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes. Hello. Adam.
Hi.
It's Chelsea.
What's up, Chelsea?
Do you know Chelsea?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Chelsea. Okay, we know you, Chelsea. Hey.
Pretty girl, Chelsea.
Hello.
New caller.
That's Chelsea. No?
Chelsea, oh, I'm sorry, Chelsea. Hi. Shout out to Chelsea.
Hello.
This is not Chelsea?
No, this is Ashley.
Okay, hey, Ashley. What's going on?
Hey.
Hey. What's up?
This is Ashley, also known as Miss High Class.
Oh, what? Okay. Why are you known as Miss High Class?
What makes you so classy?
Because I'm classy.
Hey, okay.
Oh, well, that's pretty self-explanatory. All right. Holla at Aaron Fresh. Let him know what you want to talk about. We're going to stop loving these calls.
What are these beeping noises? It's driving me crazy.
No, I'm saying, like, how come they keep getting cut off?
He didn't want to say it though. Like, he like, he was like,
I'm gonna need Aaron to come sit in every week and come get life in here, huh?
Like, how do you deal with being grounded?
These young girls about that life. They trying to get this boy.
Baby girls talking.
They trying to get this boy. Okay, how many more calls? Hey, ladies, look. Okay.
Baby girl on the phone.
We're gonna take some more calls. Yeah, Rich said take more. We can take some more calls. Come on.
One girl was just talking.
Somebody was just talking.
Now, we're going to try to cut you off because there's so many. You got to get your question out. You're on the air, Staci Harris Show with Aaron Fresh. Let's go. What up? Who, come on, talk to him. Who is this?
What?
Who is this? See, look, you lost your phone time. Next
ask the question, y'all. Ask the question.
Please. You're on the air, Staci Harris Show, talking to Aaron Fresh. What's up?
Hello?
Yes. You on the air?
Hi, this is Zoe. Hey, Aaron.
Hey, how you doing?
Good.
Oh, you got a question? You got a question for him?
Yeah. What's the craziest situation you've ever been in, like, in your whole life?
What's the worst situation?
Craziest situation you've ever been in.
Craziest situation.
You know they can right now. Right now.
Right now. I think it is right now.
What?
I don't know. Probably getting attacked at Starbucks.
All right.
Yeah.
You got a little mob action going.
Yeah.
That's what's up. He got attacked at Starbucks. That was a crazy thing. Next caller. What up, what up? You're on the air with Aaron Fresh. Holla at the boy.
That's what's up. He got attacked at Starbucks. That was a
turn your radio down, whoever this is, please.
What up? You're on the air with Aaron Fresh. Holla at the
Oh, my bad. Hi.
What's up, Mama? Talk to Aaron. You got a question for him?
Yes, will you sing Summertime for me?
Spending all my time loving you, all my time loving you. Need a few more seconds in my day. I'm spending all my time loving you, all my time loving you. Every minute's running away. From when I wake up to when I lay down, all I got is you, baby, you're on my brain. I'm spending all my time loving you, all my time loving you. 25 hours in my day. Yeah, yeah.
Nice. That's set your little heart on fire.
Set your heart on fire.
He said 25 hours.
Yeah, he said 25. That's he gave me an extra hour. That's kind of
fair.
I gotta give you
all time. Right. Thank you for calling. What up? What up? Stacey Harris Show. You're on the air with Aaron Fresh. I let the boy.
Hey, this is Ashley, also known as Miss High Class.
Oh, you called back. What up, girl? We missed you. What question you have for young Aaron?
I want to know, how does he stay so grounded in the music industry?
Ooh, that's a great question.
Honey. Actually having a question that matches your name, Miss High Class. Everybody give
you
a
so classy, Miss High Class. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Wow. Thank you.
So, Aaron, answer her with a nice question. I'm going to be quiet. Answer her with a nice answer.
I learned that from, number one, I think being in Trinidad. I feel like Trinidad definitely gives you a sense of being grounded, mm-hmm. just the people that surround you. And plus my mother, she will definitely keep me grounded no matter what. So shout out to Mama Fresh for that one. Yeah.
Hi, Mama Fresh. That's what's up. Right. You have your mom in your life. That's good.
Yep.
Next caller. What up? On the air with Aaron Fresh.
Hey.
Hey. Who's this?
My name is Autumn.
What's up, Autumn? You got a question for Aaron?
Yes, I want to ask Aaron, what is his favorite Halloween candy?
Hysterical.
Ooh, that's a good question.
Okay.
I mean, Halloween. It's
interesting.
I thought maybe costume. Yeah.
My favorite Halloween candy would be Reese's. Reese's, the chocolate Reese's Puffs.
Reese's.
Now, is that a Halloween
peanut butter?
Or is that
peanut
just
butter.
A good candy?
Peanut butter cups.
Yeah, the peanut butter cups. I like those.
Is that a good Halloween candy or just a good candy?
No, that's a
Halloween
candy.
Bite-sized.
Any candy is Halloween candy.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Reese's. Send him some. Next caller.
All right. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Autumn.
No. That's it.
All them goddamn beeps. It's like, dang, no more insured. We had 30,000 beeps.
Man, that was crazy.
All right, the power hour with Aaron Rush is officially over.
No, but thank power you to hour. Everybody that
no, seriously, that
me,
was bro. Dope. Thank you so much for tuning in and checking Aaron out. Obviously, y'all love Young and Tender. Y'all
Young and
stay
Tender,
tuned. Before we close out, I always do fails, which I already did. So I'm going to leave y'all with a success. People say, why don't you say something successful? Somebody that's failing. So this is my success for the day. Mm. People who mind their business. And with that, we're going to wrap up the show. Let me give a shout out to all to everybody in the building for tuning in. Thank you so much mm-hmm. for tuning in. We got Fresh Photography in the building, Ethno Nightlife, DGK, Stevie Williams. What up, Stevie? And Fresh, thank you so much for coming in. Aaron Fresh.
Of course.
Give us one more medley to take us out of here, and then we're going to do a nice Twitter roundup.
Also let them know, too, remind everybody, you know, about the downloading and you know.
Yeah, definitely.
Tell them about the downloading, where they can find what you got current.
Well, if you want to get in contact with me, holler at me on Twitter at AaronFresh1. Become part of Team Fresh, put hashtag Team Fresh. My single, Real Lovin', is out right now. You are definitely getting it free until October 31st, so make sure you get it now. also look out for the video November 10th. Look out for it to be on iTunes on November 18th. Look out for the project early next year. It's going to be dope. And please go online. Go online at AaronFreshOnline.com, and you could check out my website. So
everybody, real quick, do your Twitter roundup. Brisha, yeah. Shout your Twitter out.
Hey, you guys, it's Brisha Webb. You can follow me at Brisha Webb, BreshaWebb.
Wes, did you have the bark?
Have the bark. And you can follow me on Twitter at Wesley Jonathan, at WESLEYJONATHAN.
Young Fresh.
Chia. At Aaron Fresh 1, the number 1 at the end of it. So check it out.
And I'm at It's Me, Stacy, spelled with an I, and the Staci Harris Show. spelled with the I too. And we're gonna close out. To watch your dream unfold is a dream in itself. All dream big. When your dreams seem insane, you are on the right path. Keep it all the way 100. Put God first. And real quick, we have Staci Harris Show has an official launch party going down November 14th at the Zen Lounge. We're gonna have some of the big heavy hitters, Kevin Hart, Mekhi Phifer, Nicki Minaj. They're gonna all be in the building. Oh, nice. Yo, make sure you guys
Air Fresh.
Got a new young boy gonna be there.
So stop calling this man a young boy. It's been bugging me the whole
19.
Show.
He is 19.
Stop calling this boy a young boy. I've had it. Boy. I'm standing on it right now.
When he hit 21,
it's a young man here.
Got fuzz on my face.
You know,
I see it.
You do shave.
You a young man.
You know what?
I see it.
I see that 5 o'clock shadow. You know what? You know what, young and
spending all your time.
Apologize. I apologize, young.
25 hours a day, okay? Trying your hardest here.
Yeah, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Once again, Young and Tender is going to be out.
I don't like you, baby. You are so mean.
You love me.
I do love you.
Thank you guys for tuning in. We'll be back next week with another episode, 6 p.m. Pacific Time, LA Talk Live, when we are out.
In a place with young free, and I got what it takes to rock. Still watch what you say. I'll take my first 50 shots. Still put dirt to go. I'm Mr. Hood when I'm traveling. Get neck when I'm traveling. Six pack wood when I'm traveling. Fuck a Lex, cause the click fit good in a caravan. Slide through your hood like an avalanche. Take a flick if you get a chance. Get that close. Fucking advance, cause I get that dough. Beef with me. Enemies come sleep with me for breakfast. Guaranteed to eat this toast. Reckless fire starter, heat your folks. You start with artists that beat your tracks. So don't bring them around. I be around Ricans, Vida Loca. They got all the toasters, don't need no cats. I got a six stash, leave them around so I don't get left around.